Hello guys, welcome back to St. Joseph Composite PU College, Bijapur. I'm Rahul, Chemistry Faculty. Today I'm going to discuss the extension of the chemical bonding. What are the basic things are required to understand the chemical bonding topic? The one of the important concepts you have studied in the previous standards, like in the 9th standard or in the 10th standard, that is octet rule. So that I will going to explain now. Octet rule. So basically this rule is generalized rule, and this rule is given by Cosell and Lewis, and these are the two scientists who worked separately and made some conclusions on the observation of noble gases. So let's understand that what are noble gases. Noble gases. The noble gases are present at the group 18 in the periodic table, and these noble gases are less reactive or almost no reaction, no reactivity. Cosell and Lewis observed their reactivity and chemical, or you can say that electron patterns in that. The electron pattern is the last shell in the noble gas elements is 8. That is, in the noble gases, the number of electrons present in the last shell are 8. That is, last shell containing, last shell containing contain 8 electrons. Now Cosell and Lewis made a conclusion that every atom have tendency to gain or lose the electron in order to have 8 electrons in their outermost shell, and every atom want to be stable, and for that they made a statement that the octet rule says that the atom want to gain 8 electrons in their outermost shell, and that can be done by losing electron or by the loss of electron or by gain of electron. So these are the two ways are there by that the atom can get 8 electrons in their outermost shell. Let's understand something more here. First, let's understand that what is Lewis structure and how we can represent them. Now if I write here hydrogen, the electronic configuration for the hydrogen, I'm going to write here 1s1. For the helium, I'm going to write the electronic configuration 1s2. And for the lithium, the electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s1. For beryllium, the electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2. Now you just observe here, in the hydrogen, we have 1 electron in their last shell. In the helium, we have 2 electrons in their last shell. And in the lithium, in the last shell containing 1 electron, and in the beryllium, the last shell containing 2 electrons. We'll take some more examples, like carbon we'll take, and fluorine we take. So you can see that in the carbon, the electron configuration is 1s2, yes, and this is 2s2, then 2p2. The total number of electrons 6. Now in the fluorine, the 1s2, 2s2, 2p, 5 is there. Okay, here the last electrons in the carbon are 2s2 and 2p2. There are total 4 number of electrons are there. And in the fluorine, the last electrons are 2s2, 2p5. There are total 7 electrons are there. Now what Lewis dot structures are represents, they represent the valence electrons. The electrons present in last shell are called as valence electrons. They are called as the valence electrons. They are called as valence electrons. Valence electrons. And representation of valence electrons around the symbol is called as a Lewis dot structures. For example, for the hydrogen, I have to represent only 1 electron. Let me have here hydrogen it is. And around that, I have to represent 1 dot. Why 1 dot? Because in the hydrogen, there is only 1 electron is there in their outermost shell. Let me represent 1 electron here. This is 1 electron. That is the hydrogen symbolically represented. Okay, come to the helium. What do we have in the helium? The helium it is, and you can see that in the helium there are 2 electrons are there, and therefore I have to write 2 dots here. There are 2 dots. Now come to the lithium. In the lithium, what do we have? That there are only 1 electron is there in the outermost shell. You don't have to consider the electron present in the 1s2. You have to consider only the electron present in the 2s1. That is the outermost shell, and therefore I have to write here 1 electron at the lithium. That is 1 dot I have to write. And come to the beryllium. What do we have? Beryllium. In the beryllium, you can see that there are 2 electrons on there in the outermost shell. Therefore, I have to represent two dots around the beryllium. Then similarly, what about the carbon? You can see the carbon here. Let me write the carbon here. The carbon containing 2s2, 2p2, right? Total there are 4 electrons are there. And therefore, to represent those 4 electrons in the form of dots around the carbon. So this is 1, 2, 3, and it is 4. 4 electrons. Now come to the fluorine, the last one. Let's understand this. So in the fluorine, the outermost shell containing 2 plus 5. There are total 7 electrons are there. And therefore, we have to write here 7 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 dots. And similarly, let me write for the boron. So boron electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. You can see that the last electrons are, last outermost shell electrons are, 3 are there. So therefore, around the boron, I have to write 3 dots. 3 dots I have to represent. If I take a nitrogen, the electronic configuration for the nitrogen, I can write 1s2, 2s2, 2p3 I have. The 2s2 and 2p3 are the outermost shells. And therefore, here the nitrogen can be represented with the dots, like total number of electrons you can count here. 2s2, 2p3 there. Total 2 plus 3 is 5 electrons are there. Let me write 5 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 electrons. And this is called as a Lewy's representation of atoms. Or you can say that these are called as Lewy's symbols. Lewy's symbols. So what are the Lewy symbols? Lewy symbols are nothing but a representation of valence electrons around the symbol or around the atom. Okay. And itself is known as the Lewy's symbol. Okay. This is one part. Now let's understand that how the different bonds are formed. Using the octet rule, we have to explain that how the different bonds are formed here. Let's take the ionic bond. Ionic bonding. Okay, in the ionic bonding, let me write once again. Okay, in ionic bonding, the ions are produced. So let me write that first. Ions. The ions are present. And how the ions are present? The ions are two types. So you can say that cation, cation. Another one is anion. Anion. And between these two, there is a force of attraction. Between the cation and the anion, there is a force of attraction is there, because opposite charges are there. There is a force of attraction, and that force of attraction is called a electrostatic force of attraction. And because of this reason, the molecules which containing the electrostatic force of attraction, they are also called as the electrovalent bond. So ionic bond also we can refer here as an electrovalent bond, because in that electrostatic force of attraction is exist. Now try to understand that how octet rule and ionic bonding is correlated. In the previous video I was explained something related to this. Once again we'll discuss this. What I have that, let me take one example. I start with the example that is sodium. Its electronic configuration I can write, that is a 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 and 3s1. Now sodium want to get 8 electrons in their outermost shell, and there are two ways are there. Either the sodium can take 7 electrons and fill into the s orbital, that is highly impossible, and taking even the help of the 3p orbital, it is impossible to hold the 7 electrons by the sodium nucleus. Instead of that, what does sodium do? That sodium lose one electron, it lose one electron, minus one electron. Okay, and by that the sodium is converted into sodium plus. Now once again we're going to write the electronic configuration for the sodium plus. The 1s2 as it is, 2s2, 2p6. Now 3s1 is there, in that one electron is left out. Now I don't want to write here 3s, because there is no electron is present in the 3s, right? And therefore I leave it. Now 2s2 and 2p6 become the outermost shell. This is outermost shell. And this outermost shell containing how many electrons? You can notice that 2 plus 6, 8 electrons are there. Now sodium plus is stable because it gains octet. Let's take one more example, that is Cl. The chlorine atom having electronic configuration, let me write the electronic configuration for the Cl. Its atomic number is 17. The 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, now 3p5. That is 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 6, 10, 10 plus 2, 12, 12 plus 5, 17. Now, Cl can attain the octet by two ways. Either it can lose all 7 electrons from the outermost shell and it becomes a Cl plus 7. The chlorine with a plus 7 charge is highly unstable. But when you add one electron, means when you add one electron to the 3p orbital, so it becomes 3, that is 2 plus 6, 2 plus 6, that becomes the 8. That is, I just add here one electron, plus one electron. And by that, what happens here? We get the Cl minus. We get Cl minus. Now, the electronic configuration for the Cl minus, we can write, that is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, then 3s2 as usual. But now, I'm going to write here 3p5 is there here in the Cl, but one electron is added and therefore it becomes 3p6. Now, in this case, the 3s2 and 3p6 is the outermost shell. This is outermost shell. Outermost shell. And this outermost shell contains how many electrons? It contains 8 electrons. Now, Cl and Cl minus, if you compare both, Cl minus is stable. Now, sodium, which is a cation, which is stable. And there is a Cl, which is anion, which is also stable. Now, only important thing is you have to notice that whatever the sodium is given the electron, and that electron is taken by the Cl. So, there is an exchange is taking place, or you can transfer is taking place. Okay, so just sodium, metal 2 and Cl, the electron is transferred. Now, there is a cation and here is an anion. And in between these two, there is a force of attraction is exist. That is Na and Cl, they get bonded. And this force of attraction is nothing but an electrostatic force of attraction. And this bond is called as ionic bond. Ionic bond. Now, my question is how the ionic bond is formed, students? The ionic bond is formed by the transfer of electron from the one atom to another atom. In this case, how the sodium chloride is formed? The electron from the sodium get transferred to the Cl atom. And by that, they convert it into cations and anions. And they get start attracting by electrostatic force of attraction. And then, after that, they get bonded. So, let me write something here. Right, how the ionic bond is formed. The ionic bond is formed by complete transfer of electrons from one atom to another atom. So this is how the ionic bond is formed. The transfer or number of transferred electron or number of gained electron depends upon the how much electrons are needed for the completion of octet. Okay, so that is all about the formation of ionic bonding. And next, we use the same Kose-Lewis concept to explain the covalent bonding. Thank you for watching, students.